Mike.
AJ.
Throwin' sevens.
Throwin' sevens. That's right. We're at it again.
Yeah, again. We never did to begin with.
That's true. Somebody should have told me that, you know, before.
It can't be new and improved, because it was never old, and it sure as hell hasn't improved.
Well, it's better than it was a few minutes ago. I can tell already.
That's true. You know, we never get credit for how loudly we say what we say.
Where is my friend?
Where's Rookie?
Rookie, the Rookster, is claims to be having a migraine, and I asked him if he ever heard of the healing power of laughter, and I never got a response. I was thinking about calling him anyway. We can try to get him in.
Like, he smiles less than Chuck Norris.
That's implying that Chuck Norris smiles at all.
Exactly. Rookie smiles in a negative amount.
If you could somehow put a number to the, you know, like a number value, a scoring rating to how much someone smiles, Rookie would be a negative 27.
Yeah, there would be like a debit of smiles. Like you, people would owe
him smiles just because there's so much anger and sadness coming from that black hole of emotion.
I like it a lot.
Anyway, our fellow co-host is
not here. First show.
He claims to have had a migraine.
A sign of things to come.
Exactly. Rookie, it's actually not unusual for Rookie not to show up.
What we'll do is we'll get some sound bites of him just saying random shit.
That's right. We can have virtual Rookie.
You know what we need? We need a Rookie soundboard.
That's right. Write that down.
Yeah.
I'm writing it down right now.
Make it in Flash.
Rookie soundboard.
Rookie soundboard. Just you know, like 5 or 6 typical Rookie responses, and then we just, you know, we use them when he's not here, which will probably be all the time.
That's very true. Very true.
It'll be like, you know, it'll be one like, it'll be one like, you know, like, oh snap. That can be one.
Yeah, oh snap.
And like, you go girl.
He's never said that.
Well, not yet. But think of how many times that would come in handy.
I imagine it would come in handy.
Damn right.
Quite a bit.
You go, girl.
So. So what?
So what's with this? You know, it's been all over the news. The dude whose house burnt down because he didn't pay like $75 a year. I know.
Yeah.
You saw it.
Yeah. So this guy, right? He lives in, I forget where it was like Bugsville, Idaho, or something. this guy. Let's see if you can find out where that's from. I don't remember. I probably sent you a link or something.
But I'm sure it's fine.
He's from some no name town in, like, you know, Idaho or Michigan or some nowhere place, and he's from a city that doesn't have a fire department. They use another city's fire department.
Yeah.
And that being said, they
he's in South Fulton, Tennessee, it looks like.
South Fulton. Okay, so in South Fulton, Tennessee, they use somebody else's fire department.
Yeah, because there's not one in the county, so the neighboring town or city offers to protect them for a modest price.
Of $75 a month for fire protection.
Which works up to, like, what, like $6 a month?
So this guy, it was $75 a year, wasn't it? Yeah.
Yeah, it was real low.
So this guy's like, no, I don't need that. he doesn't pay his fire department bill or, you know, whatever. And his house starts burning down, and the fire department shows up and watches it burn to the ground. They said, oh, wait, we're here, and you know, our truck's here, but you didn't pay $75 a year, so fuck off.
But his neighbor did. Did you hear that? Like, the fire started to spread, and then they sprung into action, and then, like, you know, like, put out the fire on the neighbor's yard, and then went back to watching his burn. Like, dude, $6 a month, this could have all been avoided.
Exactly. And he tried to, like, pay him, you know, like, I'll give you the $75 right now. Like, no, that's not the point.
Yeah, that's the equivalent of never having health insurance, and then you find out you get cancer, and you ask if you can just start paying the $100 premium.
Yeah, exactly. It's not how it works. You can't just show up and say, I wanted insurance. You forget the term preventative maintenance.
The way I see it is, when they show up and then you say you're gonna pay the $75, that's your house at that point is kind of like a toxic asset because it's on fire. Like, would you invest $75 in that? I'm just saying.
Because I won, the fucker's on fire.
Yeah, like, I'll give you 75. I'm not gonna, I can't insure your house. Why not? It's on fire.
that would be no different than, trying to insure a sinking ship, like the Titanic. You know,
Yeah.
the captain's calling up. He's like, he had to use a telegraph back then. He's telegraphing, the mainland. He's like, I'd like to insure the Titanic. Well, it's unsinkable. Why would you wanna insure it? No reason.
No reason. Meanwhile, in the background, you hear people screaming, horns going off. And then, like, 5 minutes later, he calls to make a claim. Never gonna believe what happened.
The Titanic sank. Did you rig this? So I don't even know how I feel about this. Like the on the one hand, I mean, I can understand where the fire department's coming from, right? They get their income from the people paying $75 a month. But what kind of cold ass bastard does it take to stand there and watch someone's house burn with everything they own inside of it and saying, "Nah, I'm not gonna put that out." And they have the means right there to take care of the fire, but they
Yeah.
chose no.
Yeah, but even the guy said, like when they came up there, they were like, he was like, "Well, I thought that they'd still put it out even if I didn't pay." Be like, that's fucking stupid. Like, why would you think that?
I think what would be a good fact to know is how many people signed up for fire service that day or the immediate following day when they found out about it in that city. Oh
Yeah.
shit, they're not gonna put my house out if it catches on fire, so I might wanna, step up and start paying my bill.
No kidding. I just think it's funny they showed up to protect the other houses.
Yeah, they show up and like, no, we're fine, we're fine. We're here just in case it spreads.
Yeah. I guess I said all his neighbors that were catty corner were covered.
Yeah. It's all good. It's all good. We got, what else happened this week?
Not a damn thing. Why do you have tomorrow off?
What do I have tomorrow? I have tomorrow off because it's a holiday.
It's not a holiday. If it's a holiday, if you work for the state.
It's Columbus. I work for a bank.
Oh, you work for a bank? Okay. So I guess you won't be in there. I guess you won't be in there busting your ass working that 10-to-3 schedule, huh?
No. I do have to be on a phone call at 3, but
Random government holiday 24 for the year.
exactly. I've got like 75 of them. I was in the I went to Taco Bell today, right, to get
I'm sorry.
yeah, thank you. I wanted two cheesy gordita crunches, and that's what I wanted. And this person in front of me was like confused about the drive-through process. She wasn't an older woman, but she looked like she was white trash. So she like you automatically add 20 years to her face.
You just said you were Taco Bell. Of
Yeah,
course she
true.
was. Of course she was white trash.
What was she doing out of the kitchen, right?
Exactly.
She's driving like this little Honda CRV or some shit, right? And the Taco Bell that I was going to is being remodeled, so it looks like it's closed down. It's got like all these things on it. There's a huge sign that says open, and you have to turn left to get into the Taco Bell, right?
Okay.
So I'm turning left, and this person goes, and then like in the middle of turning left, when she's like got on, well, as far as I'm in oncoming traffic, she just stops for no reason at all, realizing that it might be closed, but forgetting the fact that I am behind her, and there's cars coming at 50 miles an hour at me now. So, I'm a little confused by this, and she slowly, urges forward, and finally I get in, to a safe zone. And, it's all but forgotten. I mean, she drives literally 2 miles an hour up to the the microphone thing so she can order her whatever. And, you know, okay. Yeah, didn't really think anything of it. So she gets her food after paying for it. She gets her food. They hand her food, and she starts driving away. And she drives up onto the curb, like to the left of, like, okay. Now, just to give you an image, like it is a tight spot, all right, a tight turn. But she turned left, probably about 10 feet before she had to, and she like went up like onto the curb right by the building, and she's like sideways, and she's like Austin powering the. You know, back and forth in the lane in front of me. I'm sitting. I was actually on the phone. And I go, oh my god, this person has no idea. I was trying to explain the stupidity that was going on in front of me, but I just couldn't articulate myself fast enough to witness all the fail that was going on. But she was backing up, and I'm who the fuck backs up in a drive-through line? That's all I want to know.
Is it one of those drive-throughs where like you're held hostage? Like there's like a like sometimes it'll be like a I don't know six to eight inch like embankment around it, so like once you're in there, like that's it, like you can't change your mind.
There's a building on either side, and there's a car behind you, there's a car in front of you. You know, it's like the movie Con Air. You know, you take the first one out, you take the last one out, and there's the middle is just gonna be filled with lots and lots of dead people.
which sounds fitting for Taco Bell.
Exactly. I mean, here I am trying to eat my cheesy gordita crunches, and my intestines are surviving some kind of explosion, you know, and I feared for the life of the other people around me. I mean, truly. Let's see here.
I doubt anyone ever goes to Taco Bell and then finishes and goes, man, I'm glad I ate that.
There may be. I think there was one documented case, of someone who was happy they ate Taco Bell, but it was a drunk midget. A drunk midget, yes.
It's kind of like White Castle. It's like you never get done eating White Castle and go, oh, that hit the spot. like no.
Unless you're talking about like unless somebody likes fiery shits, you know. If you like fiery shits, and the you know, and you eat White Castle, and you know, 10 to 12 hours later you get a fiery shit, and then you're like, oh man, that hit the spot. But you know, unless that, you know, I don't see it.
I mean, unless that was your objective. Like,
have I ever told you about the time I made emergency shit at White Castle?
It seems fitting.
I was and I didn't even have White Castle, right? I was driving down the street, right? Me and my friend had just gotten done eating dinner. We're driving down the street, and I all of a sudden I get this impending intestinal urge that I have no control over. And whether I get out of the car or not, I am going to shit within the next 120 seconds, right? Like, I have no control over this fact. And so I'm driving down the street, and on the other side of the street, there's a White Castle, and it's down a one-way street to get there. And I drove on the wrong side of High Street, which is a pretty busy street, and I turned left onto the wrong way street, and then I pulled into the White Castle, and I stopped the car. I didn't even park it. I stopped the car like just right in the entrance, and I open the door and I run out and I scream to my buddy George. As I'm running out, I go, "Park it!" I run into the bathroom. And I open the door to the bathroom, and I run in, and I shit you not, as I sat, I shat.
To the outside observer, you just appeared to be an everyday customer. Like, man, that guy is in the restroom, and he sounds like he's dying.
Unless they saw me run in there and knew that, you know, it wasn't that. I don't know what it was, but I mean, something just made me need to shit at that exact moment in time.
Well, you know, sometimes for some people, it just driving past a White Castle is all it takes.
There's documented cases.
There are documented cases. You never hear, like, someone, like, there'll never be someone on death row who will be like, for my last supper, I want White Castle. nobody does that. That's, like, that's not what you want to think of. You don't want that sitting in your gut when you leave this world.
I don't know. There might be some strange, you know, strange people who are actually,
I think. What I think.